Vishnu. I'm a student from Skilllink itself. After completing the SolidWorks course, I have done my independent project to showcase my skills, how far I'm good at. So I have designed an electric tractor. Basically, like nowadays, electric cars and automation is booming in electric. So I thought that may I do a project in electric field itself. So already coming to introduction, like tractors are essentially mainly are used for only tractive power, because we need to pull things. Like we cannot go fast with tractors, because the main purpose of tractors are to utilize farm things like tillage, etc. So companies like Solar Trek and John Deere already in design electric tractors, and they're also in use. So this is a little bit of a mini electric tractor I have tried to design. So let's proceed. Yeah, like the parts, main parts are in this designing tractor involves like chassis, motor, differential box, gearbox, tires, front and back bodies, and batteries. Yeah, let's proceed to chassis. Like chassis is the main thing. It carries entire load of the automotive. So there are two types of chassis, like conventional and non-conventional type. In conventional type, chassis is made separate and bodies are made separate, and they are joined afterwards. In non-conventional chassis, it's also called frameless chassis, where entire frame is made at a time, and only frames are added at the last. So in this chassis, I have already included a seat with it, so there would be no problem. And let me show this chassis. I have included a little bit of minor details, like I have added a cup holder for it, and footrest for climbing the tractor, and I have also added back indicators to chassis itself. And its overall length, we take it is about 1 second. It's about 2000 mm, without including tires and at all. And coming to next part. Yeah, sorry. Let me tell what commands I have used in this. Like first of all, on the front plane, I have drawn a sketch, and then I have boss extruded it, and then I have mirrored the entire part from there. And after mirroring all the parts, I have added seat on the top of the chassis. And next part is motor. Motor is actually it is used to convert one form of energy to another form. So here it converts electrical energy into rotational energy, through which it transfers to transmission belt, which will run gearbox, and through that it will run differential at the rear, and by that it will move tractor forward or reverse, etc. Tractor consists four parts. This is back car, and coming to front cover, this is. And I have drawn a extrude cut here, one simple extrude cut of square, and I have applied a pattern. And here you can see solenoid, which is in orange color. Like solenoids are used to provide a rotating magnetic field, which will run this motor, obviously. And that's coming to next part. Yeah, gearbox. Here I have used this gearbox because we need tractor to run with more tractive power. When we use this motors only with electric power, it will give only one speed, so we cannot control the speed. So I have used this gearbox so we can use more tractive power with gear ratios, so that we can pull things like using in tillages, like agriculture. So I have drawn this. It is simple, but I'm not that professional in this part, so I have designed all the part like a little bit simple itself. So first thing, I have drawn a sketch of polygon, and then I have extruded it, and then to that I have added a boss extrude to the base, and then I have revolved this shaft. I have added this gear for transmission belt. Through intersection curves, I have designed this shaft to change the gears or anything else. Like I have drawn two curves and joined them using composite curve, and then I have swept along this using plane, and finally I have ordered to cast this with an, I have added a revolved boss base. That's it with this gearbox. And next coming part is a differential. Yeah, differential is gear train with three shafts, which is actually rotational of one shaft, which average of other remaining gears. So it is usually used to run two different tires with different speeds. Actually, if we hold tight the other tire, then remaining tire will also will be rotated. and I have added a universal joint to this differential, so that it is connected to gearbox, which in turn will revolve this universal joint and will run this gearbox differential. First, I have created a differential hub. One second, I'll show it transparent. Yeah. See, as you can see, there will be four gears in this. This gear is connected to gearbox. If it turns, these two gears will be rotated, which will help to turn the wheels front or backward. And I have added this rear gear. If in case we can also use this as like a generator, so that if anything is connected to this through this, which in turn will generate electricity. That we can use for other purposes. Here, gearbox comes this four gears, and this is a differential cap. And this is differential shaft, which is added to like a universal joint. See, as you can see, universal joints with pins and all other things. And these screws and nuts are already defined parts I have used, which are already saved in SolidWorks itself. The basic commands used in this are surface revolving, thickness, sketch, circular pattern, boss extrude, cut extrude, and convert entities. Yeah. Here we see in tractors, usually we see that the sizes of two wheels are different, like front tires and rear tires, because while pulling, we need more tractive power, so through which large tires will help us to provide the tractive power. So the rear wheel diameter is about 750 mm, and front tire along with tires, it is about 465 mm. And the commands used in this are surface revolve, thickness, boss extrude, cut extrude, and circular pattern. In a plane, I have drawn this sketch so that I have revolved and created this rim area. See, using thickness, and I first surface revolved it, and I have applied thickness to this, and I have created a rim. To that, I have added this subaxle, where we can add nuts and bolts, which is connected to differential. And these are cut extrude, and I have applied circular patterns so that we can have it. And I have added this revolve. Yeah, this is a sketch I have drawn. Sorry. And finally, these threads I have made using like I have offsetted the plane and drawn these two sketches, which I have boss extruded up to the surface, and then I have applied some chamfers, and finally I have applied a circular pattern, and this is the rear wheel. And front wheel is also procedure is entirely same. Like I have used simple without threads. Like I have applied only three threads between this tire. Yeah, we come into front body. I have added lights, indicators, and cutouts for air ventilation through this. I've developed this part entirely using surface part only. First thing, I have drawn a sketch on the top plane, and then I surface extruded it. To that, I have drawn two more sketches. Using surface loft, I have created this surface, and then I have applied thickness and this cut extrudes for specific designs. Yeah, here I use this cut extrude and I have extruded surface to add this neon light, and same procedure with these two lights also. I have first cut extruded it, and then I have used extrude boss base here, and finally I applied a thin layer of glass here, and I applied neon glass light effects to this, and this red neon light effects to this indicators. For this ventilation, I have drawn the sketch bottom of this part, and I have extrude cut it up to the surface and through the surface, sorry, mean, and then I have applied linear pattern, which looks good. And also, when motor gets hit, the ventilation will pass through this, and like it is used for as air cooled engine. Like I have applied ambient LED light, red LED light for headlights, and red LED for the indicators, and I have used here like transparent glass effect and this light bulbs. Yeah, here coming to back body, I have added this extrudes and the glass effects. Like usually we don't see in mini tractors like this kind of side doors and entire covering up. I thought just it would be fun, and I thought how it would look if we add some cover on the top and some cup holders. Like we usually don't see cup holders in tractors, so what it would be like if we use these parts in this part also. So I thought of that. Here I have applied cloth material for this. Let me show. Even here I have added some ventilation cutouts so that air can pass through here and there. And I have applied. 1 second, I will show. It's not sure. I have applied fabric material which is black, and I have also added a casing for keep extra battery here, and it is directly attached to the chassis. Cutout is for chair seat, and these cutouts are for rear indicators, and I have applied sunroof glass material to both sides. And just coming to batteries, yeah, here as we are using electric tractor, I thought like it requires huge batteries here. So I have used like lithium ion batteries, which these two batteries are there in this chassis. These two batteries, one consists with 72 ion cells, and another battery consists of 54 ion cells. Yeah, basically lithium ion batteries are like they are rechargeable batteries. Like Also, they are used in mostly like portable electronics and nowadays coming with electric vehicles. And in this lithium-ion batteries, like positive, negative electric electrons pass through electrolyte to positive ions while discharging, like while we are using, and reverse, like from positive to negative while we recharge the batteries. So we can use continuously by recharging these batteries. So nowadays, all electric vehicles are also using this lithium ion cells only. I have placed them both underneath this back body. See where you can see, like this is 52 cell battery, and this one is 74 cell battery. Like there will be no hassle. Like we can directly just connect with these batteries with this motor, and we can use them. And by placing them down of this chassis, we can also save the place. So there would be no extra space for the batteries. Here I have added two more batteries. Yeah, like we use this lithium ion batteries entirely for only for tractor. Like and I have used let me show. Yeah, I have used one more small batteries. Like they can be used for lightning and lights and starting the engine, so that we can save more energy for the tractor itself. And this is the see here. This is, I have added a cup holder here. And coming to total lengths and height of this tractor, the total length of the tractor, it comes around 2200 mm, and the height is about 1950 mm, width is about 2000 mm. Like regular tractor, it differs around 30% from regular normal size tractors. So we can use only this for single person at a time. Yeah, next. Yeah, coming to next assembly. First, I have fixed the chassis at one place using fix command, and then I have added gearbox using coincident and coincident command here. Yeah, using coincident command, I have placed gearbox here, and then same using coincident and distance command, I have placed motor here in the front of the chassis, which can help connecting through transmission belt. See, here I have placed this motor here using coincident and let me come means. Yeah, using coincident command, I have coincidented with the motor base with the chassis frame, and then with mate, I have used a transmission belt for with mate. See, I used with mate for transmission belt, which connects both motor and the gearbox. Like if we run the motor with electric power, which will run help gearbox, and through this, which is attached to the universal joint, which is indirectly and directly attached to these. See, yeah, you can see differential. So which will help turn vehicle this tires front or backward what we take. Yeah, see. Using with mates, I have attached this transmission belt, and then same using concentric and like first of all, I have created some clamps here, and I have attached them using coincident mates, and then using concentric mates, I have attached this differential shafts through this wheel, and I have bolted them using already defined parts in SolidWorks. And finally, I have using same coincident and concentric mates, I have attached front and rear tires. First, I have used concentric mitt, which is in concentric with this differential shaft, and then coincident, that is like shaft in phase and rear wheel side phase. And then I have added this exhaust screws with adding concentric mitt. And these nuts also are also attached with concentric nuts. All these nuts and exhaust screws are already defined in SolidWorks itself. Finally, fender is placed using same concentric mitt. Yeah, here see. In rear main batteries are placed here, like using width mitt and coincident mitt. Like this 52 cell battery is attached using width mitt, like this part and this part, and these two side faces of this battery. And final, this 72 cell ion battery is attached using coincident, like bottom face of the battery and top face of the chassis, and these two side faces are also used with coincident mitt. Sorry. Front part of the body is also used with concentric and coincident mitts. This front body would not go past through this like below the chassis, and then using width mitt, these two side faces of the chassis and inner two faces of the front body, and using coincident. Yeah, this I have used for this battery itself. So here, using coincident, I have had coincident with this end face of the chassis to this face of the chassis. Yeah, see, I have told you like steering is just I have used concentric and coincident mitt. Yeah, finally coming to back body, I have used same width and coincident mitts. Like it is just simple, outer two faces of this chassis and inner two faces of this rear body. Using width mitt, I have a coincident with it. And coincident is like just bottom face of the back body and top face of the chassis. That is, these two mitts define this chassis. That's it. Like.